So when he saw me, he wasn't happy. Because what he thought was that the news would go out to the church community, that everybody would know that I saw him in the hospital and that he was sick with a prostate cancer. So I went close to him and I said to him, it's okay. I said, tell me, or let's talk if you're comfortable. If not now, we'll talk whenever you are comfortable. So he said to me, not now. So then a couple of days later, he gave me a call and I went and he told me the story. But I said to him at that point, are you comfortable sharing this with your wife and your children? He said, no. So I met him like several times before he came to the point where he was comfortable to share this news with his wife and his children. So I have helped several families that were going through this kind of situation. But again, it takes a lot. It takes like, you know, to put yourself in their shoes, to understand them, and to tell them that it's okay to talk about. So once, for example, with this male person that had the prostate cancer, I spoke to him. After I spoke to him, he was comfortable at the end of the day to talk about end of life, about wills, because he had a house and, you know, he had a couple of cars and he had a car wash business. So after we made several, you know, meetings and several talks, he came to the point where he was comfortable, you know, putting in the will and talking openly to his wife and his children. And he also made it clear what he would like to see, you know, at his end of life care. But it takes a lot.